Trust me, like for me, the reason why I don't want to have kids young is because I feel like me, I will be a responsible parent when I'm a parent. Yeah. And for me, the day, this is why I'm scared to have children. Yeah. I'm scared to have children. Yeah. Not necessarily scared of responsibility. The day you have children is the day you are no longer number one. And I'm a selfish man. Yeah. I like, yo, man, like, so wagwan, man, come on. Got a man in Mac in there now, innit? Yeah? I'm a selfish man, yeah? I don't want to not be number one too early in my life, yeah? Yeah, I don't mind not being number one when I'm 40 years old or whatever. That's cool, innit? I'm 27. I'm going to be 28 in 14 days. Yeah, it's the 7th today. I'm going to be 28 in 14 days, yeah? I'm too young to not be number one no more. I don't feel like I've lived the life that I should have lived so far. So I must be number one for a longer period of time. Yeah, I've still got a lot left, a lot of life to live. Yeah, that's just the way I think, innit? Yeah, you're a responsible parent. Yeah, once your child, the day your child is born, even before that. Yeah, you can't wait till your child pops out. Bro, from the day your girlfriend has a fetus in her ass clap belly, yeah? Hopefully you ain't gonna have just a baby, mum. Hopefully you're gonna be with the girl. But from the moment the chick's got the fetus in the belly, you better start planning, boy. You better start planning, fam. 9 months ain't a long time, you know? Yeah? 9 months is nothing. There's a man, I think, oh, yeah. My this girl says she's pregnant. Yeah, I've got 6 months left. Cool, I can chill. In fact, 6 months, 9 months, 10 months, that's nothing. There's man in jail who'd be like, yeah, I'd love to get 10 months. Yeah. I'd love to have 10 months left on my sentence. Yeah. Because I've got 6 years to ride or whatever. Really. 10 months is nothing. They'll call that toilet time. 10 months is not a long time. Yeah. So in that 10 months, 6 months, whatever. Yeah. You are a dad, yeah? You don't become a dad the day your girlfriend pushes out life, yeah? You become a dad the day your girlfriend has got a fetus in her belly, yeah? You are a dad, fam, yeah? Now, let's just assume she ain't gonna have an abortion, yeah? You are a dad, yeah? That baby, I don't know when the fetus is considered life, yeah? I don't know if it's at 1 month or 2 months, but whatever, innit? Yeah. As soon as that fetus is considered life, yeah, and it has a heartbeat and a pulse, yeah, you are a dad, fam. Yeah. There's no waiting until Labor Day or the water them bust. No, fam, you are a dad, blood. So from that moment, from when she's 2 months pregnant, your life is over. That's the way I see it. Yeah. When I say your life is over, it don't mean never go out and eat tins of sardines and, yeah, but you are no longer a priority, yeah? Someone, you have a dependent, yeah? And if you're a responsible parent, that's how I believe you should think, yeah? Now, there are plenty of parents out here who don't think like that, yeah? You know how you know parents aren't responsible, yeah, or they don't prioritize their children? Just observe how the parents walk down the road with their child. Yeah, you see parents. I see parents. Remember, I studied human behavior. Yeah, like I ain't got no degree in it. Yeah. Couple cans of tuna here. I studied human behavior in it, and I watch people in it. Yeah, I don't give a fuck about how much money people have got. I just like to watch people and observe stuff. Yeah, I see women. Yeah, walking down the road, and men as well, walking down the road. The parent is 10 steps, 10 paces ahead of the child, and the child is just walking behind him like a lost puppy, yeah, like a feral fucking rascal stray dog walking behind their parent. That parent don't give a fuck about that child, yeah, like that, yeah. Obviously, if the child was to die, they'll be sad, yeah, but that parent, that child is not a priority to that parent. I can just see it. I can see it. Walking down the road and your child is 10 paces behind you. No. Like, to the point, they don't even know what's going on with their child behind them. Someone could literally snatch the child, yeah, like, into an alleyway or something like that, yeah? And they don't know, because they're not focused on their child. They don't care about their child like that. I've been in Edmonton Green shopping centre. Yeah, my local shopping centre, innit? Yeah, like, Edmonton Green, like, that's on man's doorstep, innit? Yeah? 1 minute away from man's yard and that, innit? Yeah? Boom. One time I was walking through the fucking Edmonton Green shopping centre. I came out of the Ross Clark gym. Yeah, I used to go to the gym there. Yeah, we have the branch, the gym. One black girl walking through Edmonton Green, shopping centre, busy during the day, 2 p.m. maybe a Saturday, probably some, I'm sure the child's name was some hood name as well. Shakira. She's walking with one or two youths. I think she had two youths. Shakira. She lost her fucking kid. How do you lose your fucking kid? How do you lose your fucking child? How? Your child should be like a winning lottery ticket. Your child should be like a fucking golden nugget or a diamond. Yeah? Me? Like, I don't go out with my sister often, obviously. Yeah? But when I'm with my sister, yeah, this is the, I would say God's honest truth, but I don't believe in God. I'd say God's honest truth. My sister does not leave my sight. Yeah? I don't walk even one pace in front of her, yeah? She's always within my crosshairs at all times. Even when I go to the fucking petrol station, I don't leave her in the car, you know? I make her get out and come into the shop with me, yeah? Or I just won't go to the petrol station if I don't need to, yeah? I always have my eye on my little sister, innit? Yeah? Like, my little sister, that's my baby, innit, yeah? So I'm not allowing anything to happen to my little sister, yeah? Now, obviously, there's going to come a time where she has to walk to school herself and shit like that. But, and obviously, she was younger back then as well. And now my little sister's 9 years old and stuff. But especially when my little sister was a child, like, my goodness me, like, these parents here out here, they just don't give a fuck. Yeah. I see it all the fucking time and it pisses me off. I see parents leaving their child in the car and going into a shop. Their child is out of their sight. Yeah, I could smash that window and take the child out of the car. There have been children who have been left in cars on hot summer's days. And people have had to smash the car window because they can see that the child is fucking starting to boil in the car. Yeah. You don't know how hot a car gets. Yeah. Bust someone's car door open on a hot summer's day. Yeah. And you will see how hot a fucking car is, yeah? You must have opened up a car on a hot summer's day and, like, fuck, like, you open up a car like it's a fucking oven, the car door like it's an oven, and all this heat comes out. Now, imagine a child in the car. I'm talking about, like, the parent going to the local corner shop, which I don't condone that as well. That's bullshit as well, yeah? You're a fucking idiot, yeah? Parents who go to the local corner shop, yeah, for 2 minutes, yeah, should not leave their child in the car. Take the fucking child out of the car. Stop being lazy, yeah? Parents who go to the shops and leave their child in the car for 2 minutes, that's wrong, yeah? But there are parents who go shopping. See all the time, yeah? Next time you are in the car park, yeah? You will see it. Now that I've mentioned it, you will see it. You will see parents leaving their children in their car and going shopping, going Tesco's. I see all the time. Sometimes I feel like dialing the Jakes and saying, like, yo, like, cool, got child fucking services or whatever, innit, yeah? That's, you're neglecting your child. How could you leave your child in a car whilst you've gone to the shop? Like, isn't your child precious to you, yeah? Like, you wouldn't, so hold on a minute. So you wouldn't leave a diamond ring or a diamond this size on your car seat, on the dashboard, but you leave your child in the car. But ain't your child priceless to you? Like, just think about that, innit? Yeah, like, telling you, man, you see, me, I better not have a child because I swear I'm just going to fucking wrap them up in cotton wool. Yeah, I won't let my child be out of sight. I will not let my child out of sight. Yeah, there's no fucking way, man. Yeah, so, these parents out here, man, come on, man, like, I know parents in my, like, family members and shit like that who have left their children in the car. I'm like, what are you doing? Come on, man. No. No, not even at the petrol station. No. No. Maybe that's a bit too extreme. Yeah, me taking my little sister out of the car when I go to the petrol station. Maybe that's a bit too extreme. Because you can still keep an eye on him, but still, nah. Nah, man. All of that, leaving your youths in the car and then going and then going shopping. That, you are crazy. There are parents who leave their 6-year-old in the house on their own. 6-year-old in the house on their own. Yeah. Not to say that a fire's gonna break out, yeah, but children are irresponsive, irresponsible, yeah. They will do foolishness. They could all start a fire, yeah. They could get burnt or play with that hot iron and all this foolishness, whatever in it. You're gonna leave a 6-year-old in the house, yeah. We all know what kids are like, yeah. Anyone who's been a kid before or has younger siblings, yeah. There's always been that one moment, yeah, that classic moment. Every kid has done it, yeah. If you ain't done it, you probably ain't a real kid, yeah. You've never been a kid before. The parents downstairs, what's Jelani doing? I said, what's? I can't hear my child. What are they doing? Because you know when kids are quiet, yeah, they're doing something they're not supposed to. Yeah, that's a telltale sign. Parent goes up to the upstairs or whatever in it, finds the kid with Sudocrem, yeah, Sudocrem all over their face. Yeah, kids are mischievous. But you're going to leave a kid in the house on their own. Yeah. There's been parents out there. Yeah. Do your research. 4-year-olds, leaving 4-year-olds in the house on their own. Even going out to the shops for 10 minutes. No. Then you got parents leaving kids in the house with dogs. How many times you hear about them story there where the dog owner, whatever in it, yeah, they leave the kid in the house with a dog and the dog fucking kills the kid or mauls the face, tears off the kid's face, a defenseless child that gets a fucking an animal with sharp teeth and no conscience. You gonna leave your kid around a wild animal? And the worst thing is the parent has just gone to the neighbor's house and come back and seen a bloody mess. That could have all been avoided if you prioritized your child. Who gives a fuck if, see, these people that the kid's all right in the house because I've got a big dog, yeah, so no one will break into the house. But maybe the danger ain't outside. Yeah, maybe the danger ain't outside that could come inside. Maybe the danger is inside. Yeah, I ain't got nothing against no dog. Although I complain about my neighbor's dog always fucking barking, I actually generally like dogs. Yeah, I won't be a dog owner, but I like dogs. Yeah, but there's no way. Yeah, I don't give a fuck. Yeah, if I gave birth to that rascal dog, I'm not leaving my child around a fucking dog. Yeah, now obviously, if I have a child who's 10 years old and I have a little rascal chihuahua, yeah, that could just about bite a man's ankles, then yeah, I might take a chance. But there's no way I'm gonna leave my child around a dog that's even a quarter of my child's size, yeah? There's no way. So yeah, like what Nadia said, laziness. There's parents out here, they're lazy. Oh, I can't be bothered. Yeah, I'm just going to go to the neighbors. Oh, the kids are all right. No.